you, and firstly, happy Christmas. I'm William G. Stewart, and this is 15 to 1. If you've finished lunch or planning a later lunch, then I hope you'll settle back and spend the best part of the next couple of hours here with us. Well, it might be the 15 to 1 Millennium quiz, but you can see from the lineup behind me that it's not just 15 to 1. In fact, it's 25 to 1. What we've done is to invite 25 of the best of the more than 25,000 contestants we've had on the 1,707 programs since we started 12 years ago, to pit themselves against each other for this magnificent trophy. Sterling silver and gilt, it stands 15 inches high and was made by Asprey and Garrard, the crown jewellers, just for us. And the selection was not an easy task. We started with a shortlist of 100, if you can have a shortlist of 100, and cut it down to 60. And quite honestly, any 25 of them would have done. So, if your mother or father, brother or sister, or just a friend, was one of the 25,000 who's not here today, or perhaps another time. For today, here's Laura.
Leslie Webster, Ian Wynne McKenzie, Christopher Bostock, Michael Penrice, Anthony Martin, Simon Holmes, Rosemary Broom, Isabel Hewitt, Gwen Kingsley, Amy Goodell, Rose Carter, Chris Russon, Stanley Miller, Leslie Boo, Bill McCabe, Tom Weir, Mal Collier, Jim Cook, Catherine Drury, Sue Creasy, Kevin Ashman, Barbara Thompson, Nick Terry, Christopher Cook, and Bill Francis are all here to play the 15 to 1 Millennium Quiz.
Thank you, Laura. Well, I've no doubt that you'll recognise every name and face in that introduction, and they include 9 15 to 1 past champions and 6 winners of our finals board trophy. From our first grand final in 1988, Kevin Ashman, who was later a 15 to 1 champion, as was Mal Collier, who also won our Champion of Champions trophy in 1997. And from yesterday's grand final, Michael Penrice, who won the finals board trophy, and young Nick Terry. Leslie Booth was twice a 15 to 1 champion, Anthony Martin, 3 times a winner, and Nick Terry, 4 times, indeed, our reigning champion. And the others, I can tell you, are no slouches. Before we start, let me clear up the business of the millennium. I agree with the hundreds of you who have written to protest that the new millennium doesn't begin until the 1st of January 2001. And so, if you're interested, does the government. And the Millennium Commission has sent out hundreds of letters saying so. So to make things clear, our millennium, from which all of today's questions will come, began on the 1st of January, 1000 AD. We've changed the format for the Millennium Quiz. Lives don't count before the final. It's a scoring game, and I'll explain the rules as we go along. All you need to know from the start is that each contestant starts with 100 points, and that it's 10 points for correct answers, minus 5 for incorrect answers. For round one, it's twice round the semicircle, 2 questions each. And I'll explain the lights on the desks when we get to round two. Here we go. Leslie, which 12th century King of England was seized by Leopold V on his way back from the Holy Land and only released after a ransom of 150,000 marks raised by his English subjects was paid?
Henry I.
Richard I. Ian, which 16th century Lord Chancellor of England was executed in 1535 and canonised by the Roman Catholic Church in 1935?
Thomas More.
Yes, Sir Thomas More. Christopher, poetry in the 18th century. To which event in the 18th century was William Wordsworth referring when he wrote, "Bliss was it in that dawn to be alive, but to be young was very heaven"?
Is it the French Revolution?
It is indeed. Michael, still the history of France. In which year did the French Revolution begin?
1789.
Anthony, please, the old world and the new. Members of the Braganza dynasty reigned in Portugal from 1640 until 1910 and were emperors from 1822 until 1889 in which South American country?
Brazil.
Simon, the 11th century. Who was on the English throne at the start of this millennium? That's in the year 1000 AD.
Ethelred.
Or Athelred, yes, the unready. And Rosemary, please. 13th, 14th century poetry. The name, please, of the poet whose best-known work is the Divine Comedy. He died in Ravenna, in Italy, in 1321.
Dante.
Isabel, please. What's the name of the Church of England evangelical body founded by the Reverend Wilson Carlyle in 1882, which began its work amongst the poor of London?
Church Army.
Gwen, please. The 20th Century Literature and Films. For which anti-war novel, on which a classic film is based, is the German-born novelist Erich Maria Remarque best remembered?
All Quiet on the Western Front.
Amy, quotations. The lamps are going out all over Europe. We shall not see them lit again in our lifetime. The words of which British Foreign Secretary in August 1914?
Churchill.
Sir Edward Grey. Rose, in what activity or field was a man called Piers Egan a famous name in England in the first quarter of the 19th century?
Motor racing?
He was a famous journalist. And Chris, please, 19th century politics. On the 7th of August, 1840, Parliament passed an act prohibiting children from doing what very particular work or job?
Chimney sweep?
Yes, it was chimney sweeping. Stanley, in connection with which enterprise in the 16th century is the Duke of Medina Sidonia, a Spanish nobleman best remembered in England?
Spanish Armada.
Yes, he led the Spanish Armada. Leslie, please. The plague, the name, please, of the Derbyshire village, remembered for its decision in 1665 to isolate itself to contain the plague which had reached the village.
E-M or I-M.
Yes, indeed, E-Y-A-M. Bill, historic votes in Parliament. In February of 1918, the House of Commons voted to give women over 30 the vote. In October 1918, the House voted 274-25 to allow what?
I don't know.
Women to stand for election to Parliament. Tom, exploration. Who early in the 16th century published a famous letter under the title Mundus Novus, New World, which told of his discovery of a new continent?
Christopher Columbus.
Amerigo Vespucci. Mal, Archbishop Thomas Becket was murdered in 1170 during the reign of which English king?
Henry II.
Jim, please. Still Henry II. Two of Henry II's sons became kings of England. Their names, please.
Richard I and King John.
Catherine, the 17th century and the famous birth. A child given the name Oceanus Hopkins was born in 1620. Born where specifically?
On the Mayflower.
Sue, please. The 17th century. John Bradshaw's is the first and Oliver Cromwell's the third of the 59 signatures on which 17th century document?
Charles I's execution warrant.
Yes, the death warrant of Charles I. Kevin. The name, please, of the only commoner in the 20th century to have been accorded a state funeral in Britain?
Winston Churchill.
Barbara, please. 17th century and 20th century academia. In 1668, Sir Isaac Newton was elected Lucasian Professor of Mathematics at Cambridge University. Who now holds that post among the most famous academic professorships in the world?
Stephen Hawking.
Nick, please. Before which 15th century battle did which English king, on being asked if he did not wish for more troops, say, "Do you not believe that the Almighty, with this small force of men on his side, can conquer the hostile arrogance of the French?"
Henry V before Agincourt.
Christopher, please. Joan of Arc. Who was on the English throne when Joan of Arc defeated the English, was later captured, tried and burnt at the stake?
Henry VI.
And Bill, please. 13th century and Asia. When he died in 1227, his empire stretched from the Pacific to the Black Sea. By what name, meaning ruler of all, was he known?
Genghis Khan.
Your second question, Leslie. Miles Coverdale. For what dating from the 16th century and named after him is Miles Coverdale best remembered?
The Bible.
I need more than
the
that.
The translation of
yes,
the Bible.
Yes, indeed. His English translation of the Bible. And Ian, please, 19th century music. Moravian Duets, 1876, Slavonic Dances, 1878, and Symphony No. 9 in E minor from the New World in 1893. The composer, please.
Dvorak.
Michelangelo, please, Christopher. What's the title of the large painting on the altar wall of the Sistine Chapel, commissioned by Pope Paul III, in which angels push the damned down to hell on one side, whilst other angels are pulling up the saved on the other side?
It's not salvation, is it?
The Last Judgment. Michael, please. 17th century figures. For Frances Stuart, later the Duchess of Richmond, was the model for which famous British figure or symbol?
Britannia.
Anthony, please. 18th century and sport. Which major event in the sporting calendar, first held in 1780, might have been called the Bunbury, since its name was decided by the toss of a coin and Sir Charles Bunbury lost the toss?
The Derby.
Simon, please. The Church and Nonconformism. The names, please, Christian and surnames, of the brothers who in the 18th century founded Methodism.
Charles and John Wesley.
And Rosemary, please. History of the USA. In which city in 1776 was the Declaration of Independence signed and given its first public reading?
Philadelphia.
Isabel, still Philadelphia, 1776. Who made history by being the first person to sign the Declaration of Independence?
Hancock.
I need a Christian name.
Thomas Hancock.
John Hancock. Gwen, please. 17th century mathematics. In 1614, John Napier published his discovery of what?
Logarithms.
Amy, please. The 14th century. The followers of the English scholar and heretic, John Wycliffe, were known by what name from the Dutch meaning mumblers?
Lollards.
Rose, please. In which field in the 20th century were Hal Roach, Irvin Thalberg and Harry Kong pioneers and famous names?
Filmmaking.
They were. Chris, English history, Mary I. Who was her mother?
Catherine of Aragon.
Stanley, please. The 18th century is a consequence of what action or event on the east coast of America in 1773 did the British Parliament pass the Intolerable Acts?
Boston Tea Party.
Leslie, please. The 14th century in Scotland. The House of Stuart ruled in Scotland from 1371 until union with England in 1707. Which house had ruled up to 1371?
Bruce.
And Bill, please. Scotland again. The last Scottish king to die in battle died at Flodden in 1513. Which Scottish king?
James IV.
Tom, please. The history of medicine. The name, please, of the physician to Henry VIII, who founded the Royal College of Physicians in 1518.
Lineker.
I need a first
Thomas.
Name. Yes, indeed, Thomas Lineker. Mal, please. The calendar and the 16th century. Which calendar was in general use prior to the introduction of the Gregorian calendar in 1582?
The Julian calendar.
Jim, please. History of Russia. In which century was Ivan the Terrible, that's Ivan the Fourth, Tsar of Russia?
The 16th.
Catherine, please. The papacy. The last non-Italian pope before the present pope was Adrian the Sixth. What was his nationality?
Spanish.
He was Dutch. Sue, still the papacy. And in which century was Adrian the Fourth the only English pope enthroned?
The 13th century.
The 12th century. Kevin, please. Terms of the centuries. In 1600, the first minister to Elizabeth I. In 1900, the first minister to Queen Victoria. They were members of the same family. Which family?
The Cecil.
Indeed. First Earl of Salisbury and Third Marquess of Salisbury. Barbara, which 15th century German monk and religious writer is best remembered for his influential devotional work, The Imitation of Christ?
Thomas a Kempis.
Nick, please. In the Millennium poll of 100 world leaders, artists and scientists conducted by the Sunday Times, in a section headed Most Significant Figures of the 20th Century, Sir Winston Churchill came number one. At number 10 was Tim Berners-Lee. Why would he be so high on the list?
Was he his double?
He devised the World Wide Web. And Christopher, please. The Battle of Waterloo. What was the name of the Duke of Wellington's horse at Waterloo?
Copenhagen.
And Bill, please. History of Italy. Which military leader born in Nice took part in campaigns in Brazil and Uruguay before returning to Italy to fight with his red shirt for its unification?
Garibaldi.
That's round one. Mathematically, there are only three possible scores. 120, 105 and 90. Let's see who's got what. Laura?
With 120 points are Ian Wynne-McKenzie, Michael Penrice, Anthony Martin, Simon Holmes, Rosemary Broom, Gwen Kingsley, Chris Russon, Stanley Miller, Leslie Booth, Mal Collier, Jim Cook, Kevin Ashman, Barbara Thompson, Christopher Cook and Bill Francis. With 105 points are Leslie Webster, Christopher Bostock, Isabel Hewitt, Amy Goodell, Rose Carter, Bill McCaig, Tom Weir, Catherine Drury, Sue Creasy, and Nick Terry. And no one has 90 points.
Well, that's round one. We'll be back after the break with round two. Don't go away. Welcome back. Round two goes like this. Each contestant will face five of the 125 questions in the round. As they face the question, one of the five lights on their desks will go out, and when all five lights are out, they sit down. It's as simple as that. How they face them is where the cut and thrust comes in. To get started, I will give Leslie, at number one, the category of the question, and based on her knowledge of the subject and her estimation of the others, and they all know each other pretty well, she will decide who faces the question. Again, it's 10 points for a correct answer and minus 5 for incorrect answers. At the end of round two, the 15 highest scores will go into round three. Leslie, we start with the 17th century and the famous biblical chronology.
Number 17.
Mal, a 17th century Archbishop of Armagh produced a famous biblical chronology in which he gave the date of the creation as 4004. His name?
Usher.
I need a Christian name. James Usher. The next question, the history of printing.
12.
Look at this, please, Chris. This is the mark of which 15th century English printer?
Caxton.
William Caxton, William, yes, Caxton. Okay. A famous 17th, 18th century correspondence.
24.
Christopher, a famous correspondence in the 17th and 18th centuries enjoyed by two women using the pseudonyms Mrs. Freeman and Mrs. Morley. Mrs. Freeman was Sarah, Duchess of Marlborough. Who was Mrs. Morley?
Queen Anne.
And we are on to the 19th century and London clubs.
Number three.
Christopher, following the 1832 Act that extended the right to vote, which London club was established by Whig supporters of the Act and named after it to rival the Tory party's Carlton Club?
The Reform.
And the 18th century and biography?
11.
Look at this, please, Rose, and tell me, who was this 18th century figure's famous biographer?
Boswell.
A name, a Christian
James
name.
Boswell.
And it's the 17th century, science and chemistry.
25.
Bill, the name please of the Irish scientist who in his work The Skeptical Chemist, published in 1661, defined an element as a substance that cannot be broken down into simpler substances.
Boyle.
I need the name. I need the Christian name.
Don't know.
Robert Boyle. And it's 19th century military history.
Number five.
Anthony, which country declared war on Britain on the 18th of June, 1812?
America, United States.
The United States. And it's 14th century literature.
24.
Christopher, which poet and scholar had been a royal page, a soldier, a diplomat, and a customs controller before spending 14 years until his death in 1400 working on his most famous work?
Chaucer.
And 14th century, still Chaucer.
Number nine.
Gwen, please. The Canterbury Tales. At which Southwark Inn do the pilgrims meet and get an offer of a free supper for whoever is the best storyteller?
The Tabard.
William the Conqueror.
21.
Kevin, two sons of William the Conqueror sat on the English throne in the year 1100. William the Second was one. Who was the other?
Henry the First.
And history of the motor car.
12.
Chris. The names, please, of the two Germans who in the 1880s both claimed to have invented the petrol-driven internal combustion engine.
Daimler and Benz.
And the next question is a 17th century famous will.
Number two.
Ian, this extract from a 17th century will dated the 22nd of June, 1616, includes these words. I give unto my wife my second best bed with the furniture. Whose will?
William Shakespeare.
The 18th century and political tracts.
22.
Barbara, the pamphlet Common Sense, 1776, which advocated complete independence of the American colonies from Britain, and the Rights of Man, 1791, supporting the French Revolution. The English philosopher and writer, please.
Thomas Paine.
The 17th century and literature.
One.
Look at this, please, and tell me, Leslie, Who is this 17th century English writer and preacher? John Bunyan. 18th century European history.
15.
Bill, who was executed on the 1st of January 1793, thus ending over 1,000 years of monarchy in the country of which he had been king?
Louis the 16th of France.
The 12th century and the Crusades.
Number 8.
Isabel, who was the Sultan of Egypt and Syria, admired for his chivalry as much by his enemies as his friends, whose capture of Jerusalem provoked the Third Crusade?
Saladin.
Still the Crusades.
Number 19.
Catherine, which military and religious order, active throughout the Crusades in Jerusalem, Acre and Cyprus, was suppressed after 1307, when the French King Philip the Fair accused members of heresy and immorality?
The Knights Templar.
History of Scotland.
6.
Simon, during the 15th, 16th and 17th centuries, how many King James of Scotland were there?
6.
7. And the question is, the 19th century European history.
20.
Sue, Louis, who was made King of Holland in 1806, Jerome, who was made King of Westphalia in 1807, and Joseph, who was made King of Spain in 1808, all shared which family name?
Bonaparte.
And the next question is the 13th century in Japan.
10.
Amy, when a typhoon destroyed Kublai Khan's invasion fleet in 1281, the grateful Japanese named it Divine Wind. Or what in Japanese?
Tsunami.
Kamikaze. The United Nations.
Number 21.
Kevin, which Secretary General of the United Nations died in an aeroplane crash in Africa in 1961 and was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize posthumously in the same year?
Dag Hammarskjöld.
19th century charities.
4.
Michael, which charity was founded in Manchester in 1889 by a Mrs. Robert Williamson as a circle of ladies pledging themselves not to wear feathers in their hats?
The Women's Institute.
The Royal Society for the Protection of Birds. The 17th century and the history of Russia.
23.
Nick, which Tsar of Russia briefly in 1698 worked in a Deptford shipyard whilst on a visit to London?
Is it Peter the Great?
The Taj Mahal.
Number 11.
Rose, which 17th century Mughal emperor built the Taj Mahal in memory of his favourite wife?
Shah Jahan.
The 19th century, science and mathematics.
17.
Mal, which mathematician and inventor developed plans for the so-called analytical engine, the forerunner of the modern digital computer?
Charles Babbage.
The Battle of Stamford Bridge.
Number 4.
Michael, the name, please, of the King of Norway, defeated and killed by King Harald at the Battle of Stamford Bridge.
Harald Hardrada.
Yes, or Harald III of Norway, he was also. The 16th century and the English monarchy.
18.
Jim, in an attempt to prevent the Catholic Mary coming to the throne, whom did Edward VI name as his successor in 1553?
Lady Jane Grey.
History of France.
Number 8, please.
Isabel, how was the period from Napoleon's return to Paris from Elba to his second abdication after Waterloo known?
The 100 days.
Kings of England.
Number 25, please.
Will you please look at this, Bill, and tell me. This is the earliest full signature of any English monarch known to exist anywhere. It's the signature of Richard II. In which century did he reign?
14th.
History of the British Isles.
Number 7.
Rosemary, which island, which also has the name Ellen Vanin, was Norwegian until 1266, when it was ceded to Scotland? It is now a dependency of the British Crown, though not part of the United Kingdom.
The Isle of Man.
The 17th century, science and mathematics.
Number 3.
Christopher, which branch of mathematics, and then new method of calculation, was independently invented or developed by Sir Isaac Newton and the German scientist Gottfried Leibniz in the 17th century?
Calculus.
The 11th century and a man called Walter Tyrrell.
16.
Tom, which English king was killed in the New Forest by an arrow reportedly shot by a man named Walter Tyrrell?
William II.
Famous inventions.
1.
Leslie, please. Who, writing to his assistant in 1875, said, I have accidentally made a discovery of the very greatest importance. I have succeeded today in transmitting signals without any battery whatsoever.
Samuel Morse.
Alexander Graham Bell. The 19th century and music.
Number 14.
Leslie, this Russian composer was among the guest conductors at the opening of Carnegie Hall in New York in 1891. His name, please?
Peter Tchaikovsky.
And the 17th century and mathematics.
9.
Gwen, what in 1699 did Abraham Sharp calculate to 72 decimal places?
Infinity.
Pi. The 16th century and Henry VIII.
3.
Christopher, which pope in the 16th century excommunicated Henry VIII?
Clement
the 6th.
Pope Paul III. Still the English monarchy and excommunication.
13.
Stanley, in 1570, Pope Pius V issued a bull absolving English Catholics of allegiance to the crown and excommunicating which monarch?
Elizabeth I.
The 18th century and English art.
19, please.
Catherine, a harlot's progress, a rake's progress, marriage à la mode. The English painter and engraver, please.
William Hogarth.
The 19th century and European history.
22, please.
Barbara, which German statesman's policies became inextricably linked with the phrase blood and iron?
Bismarck.
Yes, Otto von Bismarck. And onwards with Lord Nelson.
25.
Look at this, Bill, please, and tell me. This is the last page of the Will and Testament of Lord Nelson. It is signed Nelson and Bronte. What is the significance of the Bronte?
It was a peerage granted to him by the King of Sardinia. Well, the King of the Two Sicilies.
Yes, Nelson was created Duke of Bronte by the King of Naples, who was later the King of the Two Sicilies. Still Horatio Nelson.
Number 6.
Simon, at which battle of 1801 did Nelson ignore the recall signal flown by his commander, go on to achieve a famous victory and be created a Viscount?
The Battle of the Nile.
Copenhagen. The 18th century and Acts of Parliament.
11.
Rose, when Prince Philip of Greece became a British citizen in 1947, it was granted automatically under which 18th century Act of Parliament?
Act of Settlement.
It was indeed. And still the Act of Settlement.
4, please.
Michael, under this Act, the monarch may not be a Roman Catholic. To which cabinet post did this religious restriction also apply until it was lifted in 1974?
Lord Chancellor.
Monarchy in the 16th century.
10.
Amy, who was the mother of the third king to reign in the 16th century in England?
Jane Seymour.
This is Oliver Cromwell.
18.
Jim, look at this. This is the famous warts and all portrait of Oliver Cromwell. The Dutch painter, please.
Van Eyck.
Peter Lely. Music and Beethoven.
22, please.
Barbara, his 9th symphony. Who wrote the words that are sung in the final movement of the 9th symphony?
Schiller.
Friedrich Schiller. And the next question is 18th century India.
14.
Leslie, which British soldier and administrator established British rule in India by victories over the French at Arcot in 1751 and over the Nawab of Bengal at Plassey in 1757?
Robert Clive.
Yes, he'd be going Clive of India. The 19th century and literature.
Number 2.
Ian, how is Mrs. Helen Graham referred to in the title of a novel by one of the Bronte sisters?
10th of Wildfell Hall.
And the 13th century and European history.
20.
Sue, what name was given to the massacre of some 2,000 French inhabitants in Sicily in 1282, so called as the tolling of a church bell had signalled the start of the trouble?
The Sicilian Vespers.
The 19th century, United States of America and business.
15.
Bill, in 1870, two brothers founded the Standard Oil Company, although the family name is now better known for its charitable foundation and the philanthropic work it does. Which family?
Getty.
Rockefeller. Astronomy.
1.
Leslie, the first astronomer royal was John Flamsteed, appointed in 1675 during the reign of King Charles II. Who is the present astronomer royal?
Martin Rees.
Yes, Sir Martin. And the city-state of Venice, please.
23.
Nick, what title was held by the highest official of the Republic of Venice for more than 1,000 years, from the 8th to the 18th centuries?
Doge.
The 19th century and Julia Margaret Cameron.
21, please.
Kevin, in which field in the 19th century was Julia Margaret Cameron a famous name?
Photography.
And still Julia Margaret Cameron.
7.
Look at this, please, Rosemary, and tell me. This is one of Julia Margaret Cameron's most famous portraits. Which literary figure is it?
Dickens.
Alfred Lord Tennyson. Welsh English history.
24.
Christopher, at the beginning of which century did Owen Glendower lead a rebellion against English rule in Wales?
The 15th century.
17th century and classical music.
Number 14.
Leslie, played at the cenotaph ceremony each year now, the aria When I Am Laid in Earth comes from which opera by which composer?
It's Dido and Aeneas and it's Purcell.
It is. 11th century poetry.
23.
Nick, which collection of refrains written by a Persian poet of the 11th century who was recognised in the West as a mathematician and astronomer was translated by Edward Fitzgerald and published in English in 1859?
The Rubaiyat of Omar Khayyam.
British rulers in the 17th century.
Number 5, please.
Anthony, which ruler fled abroad after being deposed in 1659 and lived under the alias of John Clark, but returned in 1680 to live out the rest of his life in Cheshunt in Hertfordshire?
Richard Cromwell.
The 13th century and Dr. Mirabilis, or the Wonderful Doctor.
Number 16.
Tom, which great English philosopher of the 13th century was also known as Dr. Mirabilis or the Wonderful Doctor?
Thomas A. Kempis.
Roger Bacon. The 19th century and Acts of Parliament, Tom?
10.
Amy, which specific type of punishment was abolished in the United Kingdom in 1853 under the Penal Servitude Act of that year?
Transportation.
The 15th century and English history.
Number 17.
Mal, the Battle of Bosworth Field was the last occasion on which the English crown changed hands on the field of battle. Who won the battle and became king?
Henry the Seventh.
European history over 7 centuries.
Number 12.
Chris, from the 13th to the 19th centuries, many German princes were known as electors. Whom did they elect during the period 1273 to 1806?
The Holy Roman Emperor.
The 19th century sport and the Olympic Games.
Number 5.
Anthony, which event was won by the Greek Spyridon Lewis at the first modern revival of the Olympic Games in 1896?
The marathon.
The 15th century and exploration.
13.
Who in 1498, Stanley, became the first European to travel the sea route round the Cape of Good Hope to Asia?
Vasco da Gama.
The Black Death.
15.
Bill, in which century did the Black Death wipe out a third of Europe's population?
1348, the 14th century.
The 15th century in Spain.
20.
Sue, which Dominican monk became a confessor of Isabella and Ferdinand before joining the Inquisition, becoming Inquisitor General in 1483?
Savonarola.
Thomas de Torquemada. And this is famous Americans.
Number 9.
Look at this, please, and tell me, Gwen, who is this famous American?
No idea.
Thomas Edison, the Ottoman Empire.
21.
Kevin, which 16th century ruler, regarded as the greatest of the Ottoman sultans, was given this sobriquet, the Magnificent, although he was known to his own people as the Lawgiver?
Suleiman.
Yes, Suleiman. 20th century architecture.
24.
Christopher, the grandfather, George Gilbert, designed St. Pancras Station and the Albert Memorial in London. His grandson, Giles Gilbert, designed Battersea Power Station, Waterloo Bridge, and the classic red telephone boxes, first seen on the streets of Britain in 1936. Their family name?
Scott.
And the 16th century and English history?
16.
Tom, the Marquess of Pembroke was married in 1533 and beheaded in 1536. How is she better known?
Anne Boleyn.
And the 18th century and the history of education?
11.
Rose, the name, please, of the French philosopher who in 1762 published Emile, a treatise on the raising of children which influenced the thinking of Heinrich Pestalozzi.
Montessori, no?
Jean-Jacques Rousseau. The 13th century and the dissident barons.
3, please.
Christopher, the name, please, of the leader of the dissident barons against Henry III, who was defeated and killed at the Battle of Evesham in 1265.
Simon de Montfort.
History of medicine.
13.
Stanley, which British-born American woman graduated with an MD in 1849, thus becoming the first woman in the United States to receive a medical degree?
Sorry, I don't know.
Elizabeth Blackwell. And it's the 19th century and still the history of medicine.
21.
Kevin, the first woman to qualify as a medical doctor in the United Kingdom did so in 1812 in the guise of a man. She, or he, rose to the rank of Inspector General in the British Army. Under what name?
James Barry.
And history of South America?
2.
Ian, murdered early in the 16th century, Montezuma II was the last ruler of which empire?
The Inca Empire.
The Aztec Empire. Well, that jingle tells me that we've reached question 75 in the second round. We'll be back after the break with the remaining 50 questions in the round. Please don't go away. Thank you. 50 questions left for round two. A reminder that at the end of the round, the 15 highest scores go into round three. In the event of a tie at position number 15, we shall have a sudden death playoff, and we pick up with Ian Wynne Mackenzie. Ian, the 19th century, and Lord Elgin, the 7th Earl of Elgin.
Number 19.
Catherine, Lord Elgin left Constantinople, where he was ambassador to the Ottoman Empire, in 1803. He arrived back in England in 1806. What took him 3 years to get home?
His ship was sunk on the way.
He was a prisoner of the French. The 14th century England and claimants to the throne.
13.
Stanley, following Richard II's forced abdication in 1399, the Duke of Lancaster claimed the crown for himself. Under what name and regnal number?
Henry IV.
The 19th century and Karl Marx.
25, please.
Bill, what's the title of the three-volume work by Karl Marx which appeals for a class of society in which rewards are shared equally? Das Kapital. The 19th century and exploration.
Number 6.
Simon, look at this. Which famous meeting of 1871 is depicted here?
Stanley and Livingston.
The Wars of the Roses.
19.
Catherine, famed for his influence as the power behind the throne, he was killed at the Battle of Barnet in 1471, by what epithet is Richard Neville commonly known?
The Kingmaker.
Yes, Warwick the Kingmaker. 14th century Ireland.
9.
Gwen, what name was given to that part of Ireland where English rule was effective due to the settlement made during the reign of Henry II?
The Pale.
History of astronomy.
Number 3.
Christopher, please. What specific and connected contribution to astronomy was made by William Herschel in 1781, Johann Galler in 1846 and Clyde Tombaugh in 1930.
They discovered the outer three planets in that order. Uranus, Neptune, Pluto.
And I wasn't going to expect all that, but thank you very much, Christopher. Medieval myth and legend.
18.
Jim, please. The first known literary reference to which legendary English folk hero is in William Langland's The Vision of Piers Plowman of 1377.
Robin Hood.
Parliament in the 18th century.
12, please.
Chris, under which Act of Parliament of 1707 were England and Scotland united under the name Great Britain?
The Act of Union.
Samuel Pepys, please.
Number 20.
There he is, Sue. Throughout which decade of the 17th century did Samuel Pepys keep his famous diary?
The 1660s.
Yes, or the 7th, yes. Oh. Okay. The 14th century famous battles.
Number 8.
Isabel, at which battle of 1356 was the French king, John the Good, captured by the English forces led by Edward the Black Prince?
Crecy.
Poitiers. The 11th century and history of England.
Number 17, please.
Mal, which Anglo-Saxon prince was proposed as king of England after the death of Harold at the Battle of Hastings, but was never crowned and submitted to William the Conqueror?
A Grafling.
Yes, indeed. And history of the USA?
Number 2.
Ian, this man was the third president of the United States and chief draftsman of the Declaration of Independence. His name, please?
Thomas Jefferson.
The 16th century and political literature?
Number 15.
Bill, Il Principe, the Prince, an Italian Renaissance guide to achieving and using political power. Who wrote it?
Niccolo Machiavelli.
Public life in Britain in the 18th century.
Number 8.
Isabel, what position in public life in Britain in the 18th century was held by William Wake, 1715 to 37, John Potter, 1737 to 47, and Thomas Herring, 1747 to 57.
Lord Chancellor.
Archbishop of Canterbury. This is the 12th century and English history.
Number 18.
Jim, who claimed the throne of England on the death of his uncle Henry I in 1135, repudiating the succession of Henry's daughter Matilda?
Stephen.
The 17th century and Isaac Newton.
Number 20, please.
Sue, Isaac Newton left Cambridge University for 2 years between 1665 and 1667 because it was closed. Why was it closed?
Because of the plague.
The 15th century and monarchy.
Number 4.
Michael, the last monarch of the House of York. There he is. Which monarch?
That's Richard III.
King Arthur, Michael.
13.
Stanley, in which century did Geoffrey of Monmouth write his History of the Kings of Britain, a major source for the stories of King Arthur?
12.
The 19th century and the Crimean War.
7.
Rosemary, which cavalry commander led the charge of the Light Brigade at Balaclava in 1854?
Lord Raglan.
The Earl of Cardigan. The 14th century and European history.
24, please.
Christopher, the Union of Kalmar in 1397 united three European crowns under Eric of Pomerania. Which three countries?
Denmark, Sweden and Norway.
And the English Civil War.
Number 16.
Tom, what name was given to the standing army recruited by the parliamentary forces in 1645 under Sir Thomas Fairfax?
A new model army.
The 18th century and the Industrial Revolution.
23.
Nick, prior to 1709, iron was normally smelted by using charcoal. Which Shropshire ironmaker devised the method of using coke to smelt iron?
Abraham Darby.
Nobel Prizes.
22, please.
Barbara, look at this. Who is this man? In 1907, the first Briton to win the Nobel Prize in the field in which he was preeminent.
It's Rudyard Kipling.
It is. The 14th century and Scottish history.
6.
Simon, which Scottish patriot was hanged, drawn and beheaded and quartered in 1305, the quarters then being sent to Newcastle upon Tyne, Berwick, Stirling and Perth?
William Wallace.
Social welfare in the 19th century.
1.
Leslie, where in Wirral did the Victorian soap maker William Heskett Lever found his factory in 1888, building a garden village beside it to house the workers?
Port Sunlight.
The 18th century and history of Russia.
Number 10.
Amy, she ruled in the 18th century and famously once said, I shall be an autocrat, that's my trade, and the good Lord will forgive me, that's his. Who was she?
Catherine the Great.
The 16th century and Scottish history.
Number 19.
Catherine, who was the last monarch of Scotland not to sit on the English throne as well?
Mary, Queen of Scots.
The 19th century and American literature.
7, please.
Rosemary, this woman, there she is, wrote one of the most famous American novels of the 19th century. Her name, please.
Is it Harriet Beecher Stowe?
Yes, it did. To whom Abraham Lincoln once famously said, so you're the little woman who wrote the book that made this great war. Onwards with the 18th century, science and chemistry.
15, please.
Bill, the name, please, of the French chemist who identified and named oxygen by correctly interpreting Joseph Priestley's facts and who died on the guillotine in the French Revolution?
Lavoisier.
And it's British politics in the 18th century.
25.
Bill, who in 1721 became Britain's first recognised Prime Minister when he took over the day-to-day running of the country from George I?
I'm tipping my tongue. No, it's gone.
Robert Walpole and the 17th century and European history.
Number 5.
Anthony, the Treaty of Westphalia, signed in 1648, brought an end to which European conflict?
The 30 Years' War.
Famous epithets and nicknames in the 16th century.
Number 14.
Leslie, what nickname, meaning Redbeard, was given to the 16th century Turkish corsair and Ottoman admiral Hayr ed-Din?
I don't know.
Barbarossa, 19th century battles?
Number 4, please.
Michael, which battle of December 1805 has come to be known as the Battle of the Three Emperors?
That's the Battle of Austerlitz.
And 18th century and exploration?
Number 9, please.
Gwen, look at this. A journal of the proceedings of His Majesty's bark, the Endeavour, in a voyage round the world performed in the years 1768, 69, 70 and 71. Whose journal?
Captain Cook.
And 19th century opera?
23.
Nick, the courage of a faithful wife saves her husband from execution at the hands of a Spanish oppressor. This is the plot of which 19th century opera?
Carmen.
Fidelio, 19th century travel?
Number 6, please.
Simon, the name, please, of the German who first published his famous series of guidebooks in Koblenz in 1829?
Baedeker.
And the 17th century and science?
2, please.
Iam, published in 1687, Mathematical Principles of Natural Philosophy, was the work of which English scientist?
Isaac Newton.
The 14th, 15th century and exploration again?
Number 22, please.
Barbara, Prince Henry of Portugal, by what nickname is he commonly known?
Henry's a navigator.
Medieval warfare.
10.
Amy, what in medieval warfare was a mangonel?
A kind of battering ram?
No, it was a medieval siege weapon for hurling large stones like a big catapult. This is the 16th century and history of Ireland.
12.
Chris, who was granted the title King of Ireland by the Irish Parliament in 1541?
Henry VIII.
Early Renaissance literature.
7.
Rosemary, the poet Dante's female muse and inspiration was Beatrice. Who famously inspired the poet Petrarch?
Laura.
19th century sport.
Number 1, please.
Leslie, the FA Cup competition was played for the first time. The Wimbledon lawn tennis championships were instituted and the first cricket test match was played between Australia and England. All in which decade of the 19th century?
1870s.
And the Middle Ages, myth and legend.
Number 18.
Jim, the name, please, of the legendary Christian monarch of the Middle Ages, believed to have ruled the kingdom in Asia beyond Persia and Armenia.
Prestigeant.
20th century and the Russian Revolution.
Number 11, please.
Rose, which revolutionary leader was born Vladimir Ilyich Ulyanov and was known by his followers as Ilyich?
Lenin.
And 14th century literature.
16, please.
Tom, the name, please, of Boccaccio's best-known work, a set of 100 tales supposedly told over 10 days by 10 young people fleeing the Black Death in Florence.
The Cameron.
And 18th, 19th century European history.
5.
Anthony, what name applies to the treaties of 1763, which ended the Seven Years' War, 1783, in which Britain recognised the independence of the USA, 1815, after Napoleon's final defeat, and 1856, ending the Crimean War?
Treaties of Paris.
They were all treaties of Paris. The 12th century and taxation.
Number 14.
Leslie, which tax first imposed by Anglo-Saxon kings to pay tribute to the Vikings was retained after the Norman conquest and continued to be levied until 1162?
Danegeld.
The 18th and 19th centuries and South American history.
Number 8, please.
Isabel, the name, please, of the South American revolutionary known as the Liberator, who was born in 1783 in Venezuela of an aristocratic family?
Simon Bolivar.
This is History of France and Spain.
Number 17.
Mal, which French royal house reigned in France until 1848 and was restored to the Spanish throne in 1975?
The Bourbon.
Indeed. Well, that was question 125. We now want the top 15 scores for round 3. Laura?
We have 5 scores of 170, and they are Anthony Martin, Chris Russon, Kevin Ashman, Barbara Thompson, and Christopher Cook. We have 6 scores of 155. That's Ian Wynne McKenzie, Michael Penrice, Stanley Miller, Leslie Booth, Mal Collier, and Jim Cook. And we have 10 scores of 140, and they are Christopher Bostock, Simon Holmes, Rosemary Broom, Gwen Kingsley, Rose Carter, Bill McCaig, Tom Weir, Catherine Drury, Sue Creasy, and Nick Terry.
That means we do have a major sudden death playoff. Would those 10 players please stand up? You know how we play the sudden death playoff. I'm going clockwise round, beginning with Christopher, and we need to eliminate 6 of you. Christopher, during the 18th and 19th centuries, 2 pairs of fathers and sons were prime ministers of Great Britain. William Pitt, 1st Earl of Chatham, and William Pitt the Younger. The other family name, please.
It's Cecil.
Grenville. Simon, please. Leonardo da Vinci, The Last Supper. Commissioned for the refectory of the convent of Santa Maria delle Grazie. Commissioned by whom, and therefore in which city?
It's in Milan.
Commissioned by whom?
The Medicis?
No. Commissioned by the Duke of Milan. And Rosemary, the 18th century, the battles of Blenheim and Malplaquet. The Duke of Marlborough's victories over the French at Blenheim and Malplaquet occurred during which major European war?
The 30 Years' War.
The War of the Spanish Succession. Gwen, please. Famous graves. Two saints are buried in Durham Cathedral. Either of their names, please.
St. Aidan.
St. Cuthbert and the Venerable Bede. Rose, history of sport. He played cricket for England in 26 test matches, played soccer for England, rugby for the Barbarians, and held the world long jump record. Which 19th century born sportsman?
C.B. Fry.
Yes. Bill, please. The 20th century. In which European country had two of the three monarchs who have reigned in the 20th century abdicated in 1948 and 1980?
Netherlands.
Tom, please. Myth and legend. Lady Godiva, what was her husband's name?
Leo Frank.
No. Leo Frick. Catherine, please. The 16th century and John Knox. A pamphlet published in 1558 and written by John Knox in Geneva. First blast of the trumpet against what?
The monstrous regiment of women.
Sue, please. 15th century exploration. Which Italian navigator and explorer landed in Canada in 1497, claiming it for England? John Cabot. And still exploration, Nick. Which present-day island state in the West Indies was discovered in 1498 by Christopher Columbus, who named it Concepcion, after the Feast of the Immaculate Conception?
Trinidad and Tobago.
Grenada. Will you three please sit down, and the other seven of you please stand up? We want one of you. I told you it was sudden death, didn't I? Christopher? 12th century nickname, taken from the French meaning fine scholar. What nickname was given to King Henry I of England?
Beauclerc.
Simon, please. Which German philosopher who died in 1900 is well known for his declaration that God is dead?
Nietzsche.
Rosemary, please. European economics. What name was given to the plan devised by Napoleon Bonaparte to cripple Britain by excluding all British goods from the ports of France and her allies?
I have no idea.
The continental system. Gwen, please. Science and chemistry. Which famous chart was formulated in 1869 by the Russian chemist Dmitry Ivanovich Mendeleev?
The periodic table.
Was indeed. Tom, please. English literature. George Eliot was her pseudonym. What was her real name?
Marianne Evans.
Sue. American history. Which battle fought in 1890 was the last major confrontation between the US Army and the American Indians?
The Little Bighorn.
The Battle of Wounded Knee. Nick, please. Philosophy. The name, please, of the French philosopher who coined the term and was one of the co-founders of the science sociology.
Rousseau.
Auguste Comte. Right, we want one of you four. On we go, Christopher. Which bishop, later canonised, was beheaded in 1535, 2 weeks before Thomas More, on the same charge of treason?
Is it Cranmer?
John Fisher. Simon, please. The 18th century and history. The name, please, of the Governor General of Bengal, whose impeachment for corruption became one of the most celebrated political trials of the century.
No, I'm sorry.
Warren Hastings. Gwen, please. 16th century cathedrals. 9 English cathedrals are known as the Old Foundations because they were founded before the 1500s and had secular, that is, non-monastic chapters. York, Salisbury and St. Paul's in London are 3. 2 of the other 6, please.
Ely.
Chichester, Exeter, Lincoln, Lichfield, Hereford and Wells. And Tom, please. 17th century history of France. Which 16th, 17th century French cardinal and duke was known as the Red Eminence?
Richelieu.
Indeed. There we are. We have the 15 names we need for round 3. We'll be back after the break. Don't go away. Thank you. Now we are back to 15 to 1. 75 questions on the 20th century. Again, each contestant faces 5 questions. The scoring is still 10 points for a correct answer, minus 5 for incorrect answers. And at the end of the round, the 3 top scores will make it into the final. Here we go. And we begin with Ian. And we start with literature. Ian?
21, please.
Look at this, please, Kevin, and tell me. Who is this 20th century English novelist and essayist, a famous member of the Bloomsbury group?
Virginia Woolf.
Acts of Parliament.
11.
Rose, what was the popular and somewhat sardonic nickname given to the Prisoner's Temporary Discharge for Ill Health Act of 1913, introduced to deal with suffragettes who went on hunger strike while in prison?
The Cat and Mouse Act.
European leaders.
18, please.
Jim, who is this man? He ruled his country from 1939 until his death in 1975.
General Francisco Franco.
History of cricket.
Number 22, please.
Barbara, which player has the best batting average in the history of Test cricket? In a Test career of 52 matches, he averaged 99.94 runs. One more boundary and it would have been 100.
Donald Bradman.
Voices of the 20th century, poetry.
4.
Michael, they shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. From For the Fallen, written in 1914, the poet.
Lawrence Binion.
History of broadcasting.
12, please.
Chris, when the BBC decided upon a single broadcasting system for its new television service in 1937, the one developed by John Logie Baird was dropped in favour of one bearing the name of his great rival. His name, please.
No idea.
Marconi. Ships in the sea.
2.
Ian, which steamship company owned the Titanic?
The White Star Line.
The atom bomb.
Number 22.
Look at this, please, Barbara. This man, a theoretical physicist, was the director of the Los Alamos Laboratory during the development of the atom bomb, and he is known as the father of the atom bomb. His name?
Oppenheimer.
Yes, indeed. J. Robert Oppenheimer. 20th century and music.
5.
Anthony, which Russian composer wrote the ballet Romeo and Juliet, the opera War and Peace, and the orchestral work for children Peter and the Wolf?
Prokofiev.
British-US relations.
24.
Christopher, the first meeting of a reigning British monarch and a serving American president took place in 1918. Which monarch and which president?
George V and Woodrow Wilson.
And the 20th century and China.
Number 15.
Bill, the name, please, of the Chinese leader who left the Chinese mainland for Taiwan in 1949 and governed that territory as president until his death in 1975.
General Chiang Kai-shek.
This is sport and football.
Number 2.
Ian, which South American country was in 1930 the first host country and the first winners of the World Cup?
Brazil.
Uruguay. This is famous crimes of the 20th century.
17.
Look at this, please, Mal. It's an invoice from the Canadian Pacific Railway Company to the Police Service, Scotland Yard, London, dated September the 2nd, 1910. To telegram sent by wireless from the SS Montrose. The total is £2.05 and 3p, which includes the cost of handcuffs. £1.07 and 4p. Handcuffs for whom?
Crippen.
Indeed. History of Africa.
Number 12.
Chris, please. At the start of the First World War, there were only 2 wholly independent nations in Africa. Which 2?
Liberia and Abyssinia.
Yes. And we go on to the British monarchy.
24.
Christopher, what was the subject of a royal proclamation made on the 17th of July, 1917?
The royal name was changed to Windsor.
It was indeed, from Saxe-Coburg-Gotha to Windsor. And British politics.
Number 13.
Stanley, who was the first British Prime Minister to have been born in the 20th century?
Harold Wilson.
Sir Alec Douglas Hume. He was born in 1903. Still British Prime Ministers.
5.
And Anthony, who is the only man this century to have been Prime Minister for a period during which he was neither a member of the House of Commons nor a member of the House of Lords?
Sir Alec Douglas Hume.
Yes, indeed, between renouncing his peerage and winning a seat in the Commons after he'd been made Prime Minister. World politics and women.
Number 18.
Jim, please. The United Kingdom in 1918, the USA in 1920. Which present-day European Union country did not give women the vote until 1944?
France.
Still the female vote.
4.
Michael, please. Women of 30 got the vote in the United Kingdom in 1918. In which year did they get the vote at 21?
1928.
This is the history of sport again, please.
22.
Barbara, athletic. The name, please, of the American athlete who on May the 25th, 1935, set 3 world records and equaled another.
Jesse Owens.
Still sport. History of the Olympics.
11.
Rose, Jesse Owens won 4 gold medals in 1936 in Berlin. The name, please, of the Dutch woman who won 4 gold medals at the 1948 Games in London.
Fanny Blankers-Cohen.
20th century quotations.
24, please.
Christopher, which 20th century leader, when asked for his opinion on the French Revolution of the 18th century, answered, too early to say?
Well, I've heard it said Mao Zedong and also Chou Enlai.
Well, which one are you going to give me?
Oh, dear. Mao Zedong.
Chou Enlai. Sorry, Christopher.
There we are.
The Constitution of Australia.
40.
Leslie, please. In the recent referendum on the replacement of the Queen and Governor-General with a President, in which city was the polling station with the highest number of registered voters?
Sydney.
London. 23,000 on the list. Northern Ireland.
Number 4, please.
Michael, who in 1972 was the last man to hold the position of Prime Minister in Northern Ireland?
Now then, that was Faulkner.
I need a quick...
Brian Faulkner.
Yes, indeed. And history of the cinema.
19, please.
Catherine, The Birth of a Nation, 1915. Intolerance, 1916. Broken Blossoms in 1919. The pioneering director, please.
D.W. Griffiths.
Yes, D.W. Griffith. Still the history of the cinema.
14.
Leslie, the first film in which Charlie Chaplin spoke was released in 1940, a parody in which he played a character called Adenoid Hinkle. The title of the film, please.
The Great Dictator.
Youth movements.
Number 5, please.
Anthony, where specifically did this man hold an important gathering in 1907?
Brownsea Island.
In Dorset. And famous quotations?
Number 16.
Tom, who at a press conference, following his refusal to serve in the US forces in Vietnam, told the world, I ain't got no quarrel with the Viet Cong.
Muhammad Ali.
Medical pioneers?
11.
Rose, for the invention and development of what in the 1950s have the Americans Gregory Pincus and John Rock earned a place in medical history?
The contraceptive pill.
Publishing and famous collaborations?
15, please.
Bill, in 1933, a book entitled Why War was published. Its two famous collaborators were a German and an Austrian. Their names?
Dollfuss.
Sigmund Freud and Albert Einstein. The Berlin Wall, Bill?
19.
Catherine, in which years did the Berlin Wall go up and come down?
1961 and 1989.
And the United Nations?
16.
Tom, which was the first major conflict in which United Nations forces were engaged?
Korean War.
The European Union?
2.
Ian, 6 European countries signed the Treaty of Rome in 1957, setting up the common market. France, West Germany and Italy were 3. The other 3, please.
Belgium, Netherlands, Luxembourg.
The early 20th century.
12.
Chris, taken from the French meaning fine period, what name was given to the time of comfortable living that existed before the First World War?
La Belle Époque.
And history of Russia, please.
Number 21.
Kevin, when the Russian Social Democratic Party split in 1903, one group was called the Mensheviks. What was the other group called, led by Lenin?
Bolsheviks.
And famous images and quotations.
17.
Mal, please. From Margot Asquith's autobiography. If he was not a great man, at least he was a great poster. Who?
Lord Kitchener.
And we're back to the history of the Olympics.
Number 5.
Anthony, the name, please, of the American Indian athlete who won both the decathlon and pentathlon gold medals at the 1912 Games in Stockholm, but later had his medals taken away because he had played semi-professional baseball in a previous summer.
Running Bear.
Jim Thorpe. Space exploration.
19.
Catherine, these famous words from Buzz Aldrin in July 1969. Houston, Tranquility Base here. The next four words, please.
The eagle has landed.
The House of Commons.
17.
Mal, which leader of the Labour Party had the longest uninterrupted period as leader of the opposition in the House of Commons in the whole of the 20th century?
Ramsay MacDonald.
Neil Kinnock, 1983 to 92. Famous assassinations, Mal?
Number 24.
Christopher, who was assassinated by Gavrilo Princip on the 28th of June, 1914?
Archduke Francis Ferdinand.
Yes, and his wife,
and
unfortunately.
His wife, okay.
And still assassinations, please.
Number 13.
Stanley, look at this and tell me. In which year was this man assassinated?
1970.
1968, Martin Luther King. International organisations.
21.
Kevin, please. The French statesman, Léon Bourgeois, who was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1920, was the first chairman, then the senior position, of which international organisation founded in the same year?
League of Nations.
Film and Germany in the 1930s.
Two.
Ian, please. The title, please, of the famous 1934 Leni Riefenstahl film of the Nazi Party's Nuremberg Rally.
Glory.
Triumph of the Will. History of Aviation.
14.
Leslie, in which year did Alcock and Brown make the first non-stop flight across the Atlantic?
1919.
Still the history of aviation.
Number four.
Look at this and tell me, Michael. In which year did this young man make the first solo non-stop flight across the Atlantic?
1924.
1927. Famous women in the 20th century.
17, please.
And Mal, this lady became in 1908 the first female mayor in Britain. She had previously, in the 19th century, achieved distinction in another field. Who is she?
Elizabeth Garrett Anderson.
Africa.
Number two.
Ian, please. Which Ghanaian statesman was from 1960 to 1966 the first president of Ghana?
Kwame Nkrumah.
English law.
21.
And Kevin, until the Adoption of Children Act was introduced in this country, adoption of children was not recognised in English law. In which decade of this century was the Adoption of Children Act passed?
1920s.
And the US presidency?
15.
Bill, the first American president to travel outside the USA during his term of office did so on a visit to Panama in 1906. Which president?
Taft.
Theodore Roosevelt. And history of South Africa?
22.
The name, please, Barbara, of the political movement founded in 1975 by Chief Buthelezi? Inkatha. Mount Everest, Barbara?
13.
Stanley, Edmund Hillary and Sherpa Tenzing reached the summit of Mount Everest in 1953. Who was the leader of the expedition?
Hillary.
Sir John Hunt. And history of medicine, please.
14.
Leslie, the names, please, of the American biologist and the English biochemist who discovered the structure of DNA, described as a spiral staircase like double helix, there it is, and by one of them as too pretty not to be true. Who were those two?
Watson and Crick.
And the Commonwealth, please.
Number five.
Anthony, this man was in 1947 the first Prime Minister of a newly independent Commonwealth country. His name?
Nehru.
And the United Nations, please.
Number 18.
Jim, please. The only Secretary General of the United Nations to come from the Americas held office from 1982 to 1991. His name, please.
Therese de Cuellar.
And the suffragette movement.
Number 12, please.
Chris, the name, please, Christian name and surname, of the militant suffragette who tried to catch the reins of the King's horse in the 1913 Epsom Derby, but was trampled underfoot and died some days later.
Emily Davidson.
Say it again, please, for me.
Emily Davidson.
No, it's Emily Davison, no deal. And European monarchy, please.
Number four.
And Michael, King Umberto II, who abdicated in 1946, was the last monarch of which European country?
Italy.
European literature?
24.
Christopher, Wooden Brooks, The Magic Mountain, and The Confessions of Felix Kroll, Confidence Man, novels by which German writer?
Thomas Mann.
European colonial history.
19.
Catherine, the FLN, led by Ben Bella, fought a bloody war of independence from 1954 to 62. In which African country and against which European colonial power?
Algeria against France.
And history of Germany?
11.
Rose, this man, a field marshal in the First World War, was president of Germany from 1925 to 1934. His name, please?
Ribbentrop.
Paul von Hindenburg. And history of psychology?
16, please.
Tom, introvert and extrovert, archetypes and the collective unconscious. All terms introduced into psychology by whom?
Adler.
Carl Jung. Nobel Prizes?
19.
Catherine, this woman was in 1903 the first woman to win a Nobel Prize. Her name?
Marie Curie.
And the Depression and music?
21.
Kevin, which famous song of 1932 by Jay Gorney and Yip Harburg was a poignant reflection of the economic depression that swept the world after the Wall Street crash?
Buddy, can you spare a dime?
Well, technically, it's Brother.
Brother, can you spare a dime?
Yeah, Brother, can you spare a dime? But I think lots of people sing it as Buddy, so yes, okay. 20th Century Theatre.
18.
Jim, morning becomes Electra, the Iceman cometh, desire under the elm. Plays by which American dramatist?
Eugene O'Neill.
International organisations again?
Number 11, please.
Rose, look at this and tell me which international organisation with this symbol was launched in 1961 by the British lawyer Peter Berenson to campaign against abuses of human rights?
Amnesty International.
British politics.
16 then, please.
Tom, which British Prime Minister's declared aim of making Britain a fit country for heroes to live in won him a landslide election victory at the end of the First World War?
First World War, Lloyd George.
And the struggle for human rights, Tom?
18.
Jim, the politician and human rights activist Aung San Suu Kyi was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1991 for her attempts to bring democracy to which Asian country?
Now known as Myanmar, but Burma.
Indeed it was. And this is now Britain in the 1930s.
12, please.
Chris, a London venue was booked for an event on the 12th of May 1937. The event had to be cancelled, but the venue was still used for a similar event on the same day. Which event was it used for?
It was used for the coronation of George VI.
Yes, it was Westminster Abbey. And before you sit down, literature.
Who's left? 22.
Barbara, Mr. Jones of the Manor Farm had locked the hen houses for the night, but was too drunk to remember to shut the pop holes. The opening line of which novel?
Animal Farm.
South America.
17.
Mal, who is this man, and of which country was he president from 1946 to 55, and again from 1973 to 74?
Juan Perón of Argentina.
Still Argentina, Mal.
16.
Tom, who was vice president in Argentina in 1973-74 and president from 1974 to 76?
Isabelita Perón.
Yes, indeed. And World War II, please.
13.
Stanley, which marshal of the Soviet Union raised the siege of Moscow, led the counter-offensive at Stalingrad, and on behalf of the Soviet High Command, accepted the German surrender in Berlin on the 8th of May 1945?
Zhukov.
Yes, Marshal Zhukov. Science and physics.
15.
Bill, the idea that energy is radiated and absorbed in multiples of tiny packets was proposed in 1900 by Max Planck. The name of this theory?
Quantum theory.
And women in British politics?
14.
Leslie, what political first was achieved by Margaret Bondfield in 1929?
She was the first woman cabinet minister. Minister of Labour.
She was indeed. And Acts of Parliament?
13.
Stanley, which act was passed in 1911 during a spy scare and was intended to protect the nation by forbidding government employees from passing on sensitive information?
Official Secrets.
And 20th Century Literature?
I think it must be 15.
It will have to be. And Bill, in which decade were T.S. Eliot's poem The Wasteland, James Joyce's novel Ulysses, and George Bernard Shaw's play St. Joan, all published?
The 30s.
1920s. That's round three. Laura, the scoreboard, please.
And here's how the scoreboard finished up. At the top is Kevin Ashman with 220 points. And then Anthony Martin, Jim Cook, Barbara Thompson and Christopher Cook, all with 205 points.
Thank you, Laura. Well, Kevin Ashman has himself a place in the final. Anthony Martin, Jim Cook, Barbara Thompson and Christopher Cook have to face a sudden death playoff for the other two places. Here we go. Would you like to stand up, please, the four of you? Anthony, the first question in the sudden death playoff. 20th century USA. In January and February of 1912, two new states joined the USA. Either of the two, please.
New Mexico.
That'll do. And Arizona. Jim, please. British politics. In which general election did the Conservative Party win the largest number of votes ever cast for any party in a general election? 14,092,891.
1993.
1992. Barbara, please. If Edward VIII had not abdicated in 1936, but died, as he did childless, in 1972, who would now be on the British throne?
Queen Elizabeth.
Yes, she would. And Christopher, please. The 20th century and music. The Leningrad Symphony, the opera Lady Macbeth of the Mtsensk district, and the music for the film The Memorable Year 1919. Works by which Russian composer?
Shostakovich.
Indeed. Round we go again. We need to get rid of just one of you, if you don't mind me putting it like that. Anthony, sport and tennis. Who in 1938 was the last British finalist in the men's singles at Wimbledon?
Fred Perry.
Bunny Austin. Barbara, please. The 20th century, the Antarctic. Seven countries have made territorial claims in the Antarctic. Britain, France, Australia and New Zealand are four of them. Two of the other three, please.
Norway. What were the countries you mentioned?
No, I
Sorry.
Can't give it.
Russia.
Norway, Argentina and Chile. Christopher, please. 20th century Russia. In March 1918, Moscow became the Russian capital. Which city had been the capital until 1918?
St. Petersburg.
Well, Petrograd. It was St. Petersburg up to 1914, so yeah, okay. We need one more for the final. Anthony and Barbara, would you please stand up? Anthony, the suffragettes. The motto of the first issue of the journal Revolution, published in 1868. Men, their rights and nothing more. Women, what comes next?
Their rights and nothing more.
Their rights and nothing less. And Barbara, please. History of aviation. In June 1979, Brian Allen took off from the coast of Kent and flew to the coast of France in his aircraft called the Gossamer Albatross. The flight took 3 hours. In what way was this a history-making journey?
It was a man-powered flight.
It was the first man-powered flight across the Channel. Yes, it was. Well, there you are. After the break, Kevin Ashman, Barbara Thompson and Christopher Cook will be here for the final of our Millennium Quiz, indeed the Millennium Quiz. Please stay with us.
Three surviving contestants in the 15-1 Millennium Quiz are Kevin Ashman from Winchester, who was the grand final winner in Series 3, Barbara Thompson from Redcar, who was the top of the finals board winner in Series 9 and the winner of the grand final in Series 10, and Christopher Cook from Amersham in Buckinghamshire, who was the top of the finals board winner in Series 15.
Thank you. Welcome back. A reminder that this is what the next few minutes are about. The 15-1 Millennium Trophy. Kevin Ashman, Barbara Thompson and Christopher Cook bring their scores from the last 250 questions into the final, and we now revert to the familiar format of 15-1 Grand Finals. 40 questions, all on the buzzer. Correct answers, 10 points. Incorrect answers cost lives. Here we go. Literature. Which major 17th century work takes more than 10,000 lines in 12 books? Kevin?
Paradise Lost.
It does. History of printing. This 15th century German originated a method of printing from movable type. Kevin?
Johann Gutenberg.
Indeed. The 15th century. The name, please, of the infamous mass murderer who died in Transylvania in 14... Christopher?
Vlad the Impaler.
Indeed, in 1477. The 1970s and politics. Which president of a South American country, his nation's first democratically elected Marxist head of state? Christopher?
Allende.
Indeed. In Chile? 19th century European history. Who reportedly said in 1864, if Lord Palmerston sends the British army to Germany, I shall have the police arrest them? Christopher?
Bismarck.
Yes, Otto von Bismarck. The 16th century and art. Where specifically can the work of art from which this detail is taken be seen? Christopher?
Sistine Chapel.
Yes, it's Michelangelo. And the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. The Royal Navy. When it was launched by the Royal Navy in 1906, it was... Kevin?
Dreadnought.
Wow. It was well interrupted. Its name meaning fear nothing. Roman Catholicism. Two women are classified as doctors of the church. That is... Christopher?
St. Teresa of Avila.
Yes, she was one. I was going to ask you for one. The other, St. Catherine of Siena. Albert Einstein and E equals mc squared. There he is. Probably the most famous equation of the 20th century. What is E equals mc squared, Christopher?
Energy equals mass times the square of the speed of light.
Okay. World War I and World War II. Three men served in the British cabinet during both the First and Second World Wars. Winston Churchill was one. Kevin?
Beaverbrook.
Yes, Lord Beaverbrook and Lord Simon. And which Emperor of France died in exile in Britain in 18... Christopher?
Napoleon III.
He did indeed. Sport, the 1966 World Cup final. Three West Ham United players were in England's World Cup winning team. Barbara?
Bobby Moore, Jeff Hurst and Martin Peters.
That wasn't going to be the question. Which other club fielded two players in the England team and who were they? Manchester United, Bobby Charlton, Nobby Stiles. Will you look at this, please, and tell me? Kevin?
Guernica.
Yes, it is Guernica from Picasso's famous painting. The Olympic Games. Which is the unique Olympic achievement of the American Eddie Egan, who won... Kevin?
He won medals in, or won gold medals in both the Summer and Winter Olympics.
He did, indeed. 16th century mathematics. What mathematical sign was introduced in 1557 by Robert Record, postulating that nothing else could possess the, quote, sameness as a pair of parallel lines? Christopher?
Infinity.
The equal sign. 20th century warfare. Which two similar medieval weapons were outlawed, at least against Christians? Christopher?
The longbow and the crossbow.
Indeed they were. The Lateran Council of 1139. The 17th century and famous trials. Who faced two trials in the 17th century? The first in 1603. Christopher?
Galileo.
Sir Walter Raleigh. Look at this, a two-part answer, please. Although much remains obscure and will long remain obscure, I am fully convinced that species are not... Kevin?
Charles Darwin, Origin of Natural Species.
Yes, Charles Darwin, on the Origin of Species. Monarchy. How many British monarchs of the 20th century were born after Queen Victoria? Christopher?
One.
Yes, the present Queen. The 18th century and political terminology. The political use of the terms left and right originated from the seating in which countries, Kevin?
The French Revolutionary Assembly.
Yes, the National Assembly in France. Famous sayings, and this is the theatre. I want two names, please. The theatrical expression, break a leg, derives from the fact that a famous assassin did, in fact, Kevin?
John Wilkes Booth, Abraham Lincoln.
Yes. Wilkes Booth broke his leg, but he jumped onto the stage after the assassination. The span of a man's outspread arms is equal to his height. That extract from whose notebooks describes... Barbara?
Leonardo da Vinci.
Indeed, yes, so that's what it was all about. News and the 19th century. Which company, now the world's biggest supplier of news, originated in 18...
Christmas? Reuters.
Yes, Reuters, 1851 in London. Sport in the 19th century. Which popular spectator sport reputedly began in 1873 when two Welsh farmers arguing over who had the better dog settled their dispute with a contest? Kevin?
Greyhound racing.
Sheepdog trials. On we go, please. The 17th century. Good friend, for Jesus' sake, forbear to dig the dust enclosed in here. Kevin?
It's on Shakespeare's tomb.
It is indeed, on the tomb of William Shakespeare. In 1974, in the Chinese city of Xi'an, an archaeological excavation unearthed... Barbara?
It's Terracotta Army.
Yes. Lucky there, because I was going to ask you what they were made of, those 6,000 figures, but and there's a quick glance at them. Look at this, please. This man, in 1865, founded the Christian mission in the East End of London. Kevin?
It's William Booth.
Anything
else? The Salvation Army.
Yes, I was going to ask you what the movement was now called. William Booth, the Salvation Army. Astronomy. Which Renaissance astronomer first proposed the heliocentric theory? Kevin?
Copernicus.
Yes, early in the 16th century. Still astronomy. And which Italian scientist and astronomer? Kevin?
Galileo.
Yes, indeed. Faced the Inquisition in Rome for espousing Copernicus's theory. Look at this, please, and tell me, who is this romantic Barbara?
It's Lord Byron.
And two names, please. 23 years ago, dear grandmama died. I wonder what she would have thought of a Labour government. Barbara?
It's Queen Victoria and George V.
Yes, from his diary. And 20th century quotations. A famous telegram from a famous American humorist. It read, streets flooded, please advise. Kevin?
Robert Benchley. Robert Benchley about Venice.
Indeed, in Venice. This Russian activist who played a leading role... Christopher?
Trotsky.
Yes, Leon Trotsky, yes. Museums in the 19th century. Which museum, opened in 1881, lies on a 14-acre site in London and has over 68 million specimens, including... Kevin?
Natural History Museum.
Yes, 28 million insects, 9 million fossils, and 3,200 meteorites. Look at this and tell me, this clothed skeleton... Kevin?
Jeremy Bentham.
Yes, and there's a shot of his feet with his head on the floor, which gives a new meaning to the expression, his head between his legs. The American Civil War, two names, please. Which general of the Southern states surrendered to which general? Kevin?
Robert E. Lee surrendered to U.S. Grant.
Indeed, at Appomattox Courthouse. Honours and awards. The first actor given a knighthood was Henry Irving. Christopher?
So, Beerbohm Tree, I'll say the second one.
No, in 1895, who in 1970 was the first actor elevated to the peerage, Laurence Olivier. You've lost your three lives, Kevin and Barbara, it's you two. Who are these 19th century young women? Barbara?
Anne Emily and Charlotte Bronte.
They are the Brontes. Branwell, their brother who painted the picture, was in the middle, but he later painted himself out. Physiology. Which protein hormone produced by the pancreas was first isolated? Kevin?
Insulin.
It was. Frederick Banting and Charles Best in 1921. Westminster Abbey was founded during the reign of which famously pious King of England? And Barbara?
Edward the Confessor.
Indeed. What can I say? What a great final. Barbara, 265 points. Christopher, 315. Kevin, I've said this before to you on one occasion. I'll say it again. Laura has something for you.
Here we are. It's been many years. Well done.
What can I say? Just accept. Well done, Christopher. Well done, Barbara. And well done, young Kevin. And in the excitement, I forgot to mention the score is 400. Well, that's it. It only remains for me to wish you all a happy rest of Christmas Day, Boxing Day, and the rest of the holiday, and whatever you're planning for New Year's Eve. We'll be back with a new series on Monday, the 3rd of January. But next week, for any of you who suffer withdrawal symptoms, well, we're not on, there's a chance to see again four programmes on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday from our highest scores list, starting with Bill McCaig's maximum possible score of 433. Thank you for being with us.
Those special high-scoring 15-1 start on Monday at 4 o'clock. Next today, where you have 15-1, you should always follow it with Countdown. And we're sticklers for tradition.